spiritual paralysis, right?
Right.
But today we're going to deal with spiritual parasites. Mm-hmm. Now, I was reading and really meditating on Hosea, and all these different things came out. And so one day I was hearing this preacher talk about don't eat pork and the side effects of pork, right?
Yes.
And I'm like, okay, you know, I've heard of that before. But then someone decided to do a little documentary. They pulled some coke on the pork chop.
Yeah.
And they got these little clips, little tweezers, and started pulling out maggots. Right?
Yes.
And so it brought back to my imagination. I remember when I was a little kid, and I'm not sure if I heard it right, but I remember hearing about, I think it was my mother's friend, that died because of, they had like, I think worms in the heart or something like that. And so I never thought about that. Then to hear about people that said they had worms in their skin, or they used the washroom with the worms in their stool and stuff, and I'm like, okay, how the heck did you get worms in your body? And as I began to study this, I began to realize that there's a lot of different things that are in us that is destroying our walk with God, causing us to leave God and die in the same process.
Yes.
Because as pork, when you eat it, it gets into your system and it gets so bad to the point, because it says, with pork, let me rephrase this. How many of you ever heard they said, well, God, people have misquoted Paul to the point that Paul had to go revisit that particular text in a later text to tell how people were misinterpreting his text when he said that God had done away with the law.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Now, in Leviticus 11, and you read this on your spare time so that you can get some healing and deliverance in your life.
Okay.
It speaks about the things that God said that we can eat and we cannot eat.
Exactly.
Okay. Things that we have to cure, things we have to do this to and do that to before we eat it. Mm-hmm. But as time went by, and you know, as time went by, slavery went by, slavery, they feed us any and everything, and as they begin, and that's what we call soul food.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
yes.
We get the chitlins, they say from the rooter to the tutu, they cook it, mm-hmm. and so forth. Mm-hmm. But then in the end, you notice how you notice that people have those big protruding bellies.
Yes.
In reality, the stomach is right here, this is the intestines.
Mm-hmm.
And so they get all these different things. And the thing is, when these parasites get inside of you, they come out your skin.
Yes.
Like little worms.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Or you pass gas and you see them in your underwear. Or you know, it just, because it's housing in your stomach, so it comes out your waist. And people fail to realize, I was looking at this video, and the video they had, it was cutting this guy's stomach, and they were just pulling out the parasites. And the parasites looked like, they were like lone worms, and they just pulling them out, and pulling them out, and pulling them out. And what happened is they are leeches who leech onto you.
Mm-hmm.
Pay close attention now, because mm-hmm. we're going to go somewhere deep into this topic. They're leeches that leeches off your body, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So they're drinking and training. So if they're doing that, think about all the GMOs, CMOs, and all the steroids and the infected food that we eat, causing it to grow even more,
mm-hmm.
causing people to have these different things. Now, have you ever been seeing someone that go to deliverance service, that go get prophesied over, that go and they're seeking God for deliverance and not knowing why they can't get delivered?
Mm-hmm. Come on.
And you say, why I can't get delivered, why I can't deliver? And last week we talked about how people talked about they can't get delivered of anger, they can't get delivered of mood swings, fear, nervousness, anxiety, the shakes, the twitches, and stuff like that. It's because of caffeine.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we had our conversation on the way home. Okay, then what about decaffeinated? Well, decaffeinated plays a deeper role into its heart disease.
Mm-hmm.
So you're wondering why you get the twitches in your arm or your heart kind of beats irregular. Because we're praying and we're in this line asking someone to help us go through deliverance. In reality, what we're doing, we're at home feeding this demon.
Yes.
So when we get in line, this demon's not going anywhere because we're nursing this demon every time we get a chance.
Mm-hmm.
Through food and liquids and so forth.
Mm-hmm.
But yet we got people that prophesy everywhere you go and tell you all these different things. Why aren't they telling you that you need to stop drinking this, you need to stop doing that, and you can get your deliverance? You didn't ever think it was strange when you looked at Jesus and you looked at Daniel and you looked at many other the prophets of old and apostles of old and ministers of old? You notice how important the Bible fasting was?
Yes, yes.
Yes.
Why was fasting important?
Cleansing
of the body. I'm glad you asked. And I'm glad you participated. Let's look and see why cleansing was so important. As we begin to look over at Daniel 10:13, you go over there. and or write your notes. We're gonna, I'm gonna paraphrase over it, or I might touch on it as well. You notice that in there, that's the one where it talks about the Prince of Persia,
right? Yes.
And it talks about how, you know, but these things didn't happen until Daniel went on his 21-day fast.
That's right.
What's taking place on Daniel's 21 fast? He's eating nothing but fruits and vegetables, water and healthy stuff. He's eating from the earth, clean stuff. So that means he got to clean his fruits and stuff like that before he eat it. Some are steamed, some are raw. But he has to be more in tune with his with what he's eating for 21 days. So what is happening? 24 days, if he have any sickness, disease, or parasites in his body, it's flushing it out.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
That means that even if he's holding back weight, because we're supposed to be able to, not to sound gross, we're supposed to have an elimination every day.
Yes.
But if we're not having an elimination every day, we got to ask the question, what's holding me up? That's a word in itself.
Yes, it is.
What's holding you up? What's getting you sick? Who's feeding you in what you're eating is what we asked last week, right?
Right.
And the thing is, let's now you say, okay, this is church. This is not a nutrition class. Okay, I'm glad you decided to go that route. Let's take it to church. We have scavenger preachers,
come on,
Christians, and people who are in the church who are scavengers. Now, who are scavengers? Scavengers are the ones that we eat off of that give us the parasites.
Come on.
Okay.
And we just chew it up.
So we keep eating everything that they give us, but we're wondering why when we get home we're frustrated and we're sick and we're going through. And even when they even have the little the church soiree, I don't know why I heard that word in my mind. The church soiree or the church get together. Do they not just have coffee and cookies?
Yes.
You know, and chocolate and all these different things. And it's rare. And it's rare to the point where I have never really seen it. I might have saw it yesterday. My mind just blocked it out. But shouldn't we have fruits and vegetables at the soiree?
We may
have
it.
Yeah.
We may have it one section.
Yeah. Something that will cleanse our bodies while we're going through. Because when you're on medication, certain medications really don't go with coffee, but they don't tell you. Because coffee causes low and high blood pressure. You know, if you jump up real fast and you get lightheaded, or your heartbeat stops irregularly, or you find yourself nervous or panicky or going through mood swings and don't know why you're mad and know why you're going through things. And you're going through all these anxieties and all of a sudden you're wondering, God, what's wrong with me? Am I losing my mind? And you're not losing your mind. What's happening is you're feeding a demon inside of you. How many of you ever said I had to do soul searching?
Yes.
Meaning that I have to search my mind and see what's going on with me. And no matter how much I search my mind to find out what's going on with me, I never find out that it's what I'm eating that's killing me. Mm. That's why when you see people, when they give their life to Christ in the Bible days, what happened? Jesus said, if any man be in who?
Christ.
Not Jesus, Paul said, if any man be in Christ, he is a what?
New creature.
How is it possible that I can be a new creature without getting rid of my old nature?
That's true.
So when a believer gives their life to Christ, or a person that's coming from one way of life to a new way of life, they begin to read the Bible. And when they read the Bible, they begin to realize, okay, oh, I can't eat this, I can't eat that. But then what happened is the scavenger comes along and tells you that God had done away with the law, so you can eat anything as long as you bless it. Because then they use that scripture where God was talking to Peter. He was talking to Peter, telling him, look, eat this, eat that, and eat that. And he said, look, I ain't never ate anything unclean in my life. But see, they fail to realize because scavengers never do their homework. They just catch on to click. They catch on to hook words and cliches and run with it. So by them catching on to hook words and cliches and running with it, what takes place is they wind up having other people eat from their plate. And when you eat from their plate, what happens is you get these things called worms.
Do you know who gave you the worms?
Yeah, buddy.
You're wondering why you're cramping over. You know, why you're feeling the way you're feeling, why my blood is infected, why I'm going through what I'm going through. I read my Bible every day, I pray every day, I fast every day, but you don't fast every day, because if you could decide to say, you know what, my body's not feeling well, the doctor that gave me a negative report, it's time for a 21-day. Fruits and vegetables. Why is that the hardest thing to do? Because what's happening is you're going through a mental, physical, and spiritual cleansing. And when you go through a mental, physical, and spiritual cleansing, these demons and these spiders and these ticks and things that leech onto your body can't live anymore.
Yes.
Because what's happening is the word is an antivirus. Mm-hmm. It's the antidote. And it's the thing that's needed to feed and heal your body and set you free. No matter what you're going through, the word of God is the antidote and the antivirus. I was having the Joe's Osteen moment when I was doing this. But we got to understand As we begin to read the Word begins to open up doors and windows and help us to understand where we're missing it at. Mm-hmm. I was talking to a lady, and her name is, I forget what her title is, so I just said minister, Broomfield. Mm-hmm. What's her title?
Soon to be apostle,
actually. Yeah, that's right, yeah. We'll say Apostle Broomfield. I was talking to her about time, season, realms, and dominions. Mm-hmm. People are quick to prophesy to us. I'm not getting off point. I promise you I'm going to get back to one more. People are quick to prophesy to this is your season. God is into a shift. Religion and stuff like dominion, stuff like that. But they fail to realize that God's time and human time are totally different. So while you're waiting right now for something someone prophesied, because what happened was they were just prophesying, they were just speaking what they think into your life and said, thus said God. But they see, but by us not doing our homework, that scavenger caused us to bite off of it, and now we're wondering why our bodies are being infected. See, because we're being affected by the same thing that's infecting them. See, you ever see any horror movies, how you ever watched, you notice how we're in a season of zombie movies?
Oh, yeah.
You got to pay close attention when we're getting to the season of certain movies. Because there's a demonic force that's in the air that's connected to those things. I think it's not strange that CDC, the chemical, what do you call it, you know, the people that deal with national disasters and chemical warfare and stuff like that. They get not strange that they have things for zombies, and all it is just a simple fact of a spiritual attack, a demonic force that took over the body to the point that it's almost like it's not compatible with that person, so it causes them to go through a blind state. So it looks as if they're like this undead, but in reality, you would never know what a true zombie looked like.
Right.
If we look at, I'm going to get into our topic in a minute, but let me go that there. We look at what Jesus said when Jesus left them, he told them to go out. We looked at how Jesus, before he dispatched his disciples, he sent them out two by two.
Yes, he did.
It is hard for two ministers to get along because the devil always caused them to conflict with each other. Yeah. So when you are assigned to a certain person, and that certain person has the key to release you into what God is taking you, it's the biggest conflict ever.
Yes.
Because what's taking place is the enemy do not want that to happen, because if it's like this, it's almost like what I say, for instance, me or Brother John, Evangelist John, or me and Sister Hunt. If I release the right thing at the right time into one of them, what's happening is they could be so dangerous, but they could be more dangerous than they can imagine or dream of to the enemy. They could be more dangerous and dramatic to the demon in a sick mode as well as in a well mode.
Yeah.
But what happened is he sent them out two by two. See, because where two or more gathered together in my name, there I'm in the midst. It's more deeper than what you can dream or imagine just in that little text itself. Yes. So he sent them out, but when he sent them out and told them about preach the kingdom, didn't say preach anything else but the kingdom.
Yes.
He said don't take any money with you and don't take any money from anybody. But if you want anybody to come in and preach at your church, you got to have a big, what do you call it, RM. You gotta have big paycheck for them.
Yes,
I can't think of that word. And it's like he said, I want you to go two by two. I want you to preach the kingdom and repentance. And when you do this, you shall lay hands on the sick, right? Lay hands on the sick, cleanse the leper, which is the disease, heal the sick, cleanse the leper, raise the dead, okay? So the question is, how did they get sick? How did they get diseased? And how did they die? Mm-hmm. How did you get sick? How did you get infected? Mm-hmm. And how did you die?
Mm-hmm.
See, because it's hard to raise somebody from the dead when they already poisoned themselves and they got so caught up in religion. Religion is the biggest parasite ever. Mm-hmm. So that means that you might, at one place you might go, you might get a couple of manifestations and they pull a couple of things out of you, but then you turn around You might go someplace else and you might mess around and eat from an ill, unprepared plate of food, mm-hmm. and that parasite begins to feed onto that other parasite. Mm-hmm. See, because you gotta remember, when parasites, when insects, parasites or bugs lay eggs, they lay things called larvae, mm-hmm. meaning that they lay like 100 and some eggs at one time.
Yes.
So for one parasite, that's 1,000. For 2,000, and so on and so forth.
Mm-hmm.
So he said the only way that you can really truly get cleansed of it is to have a colon cleanse.
Mm.
Do you understand the importance of fasting now?
Yes.
Because see, when you begin to start fasting, what happens is it begins to deliver you. Because what happens is when we understand true fasting, we understand that we're reading the Word.
Mm-hmm.
The Holy Spirit begins to guide you to the certain texts to study.
Right.
And as you begin to study these texts, it begins to speak to the disease that's in your body. Did you notice that at the end of his, while he was in his 21-day fast, or some part of the 21 fast, if not at the end of Daniel 21:55, the angel came and said, sometime later, the angel came and said, I would have been here sooner, but the prince of Persia withstood me.
Yes.
Think if he wasn't on the fast, think how much longer it would have took that angel to get to him. You've been praying for a long time for God to heal your body.
Uh-huh.
For God to bring you out of certain situations, to heal your mind, to heal your household, to heal certain situations in your life. But something is holding it up. Demonic forces are holding it up. And like I was talking to the apostle, Apostle Bloomfield, I said, the sad part about it is we're guilty of watching people get murdered by the devil,
yes.
and give God victory. It was their time. God decided to come in his garden and pluck up a flower. We say all these different things to justify that we fell asleep on the job and we watched somebody die right in front of us.
Yes, amen.
It's just like watching somebody argue and get beat in the head and we just sit there and don't call the police and don't do anything.
Mm-hmm.
Nowadays, it's best just to call the police and not get involved. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
But we sit there and we watch it and we just say, okay, well, it was God's will. And it wasn't God's will for that little boy to die.
Mm-hmm.
Demonic forces, they dispatch spirits from the four corners of the earth. Meaning the four corners of the streets. If you have a church that has more than two, if you have a block that has more than two churches on the block,
uh-huh.
that block should be demonic free.
Amen.
But it's hard for it to happen because you got a lot of preachers that don't want to get together and realize that it's time for preachers to get together and preachers to fast.
Yes, yes, yes. Amen.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
To get their intercessors together. And their intercessors to pray for the preachers while the preachers are fasting,
mm-hmm.
for this demonic thing to release itself from off the community.
Mm-hmm.
Look at it. Why is the devil trying to kill our children at such a young age? You turn on the television, you flip the screen, and what do you see?
Murder.
You see murder. In the school lot, while the kids are playing, the guys decide they want to run through the field and kill the children.
Mm-hmm.
Spiritual parasites are eating away at churches every single day.
Yes, yes, yes.
And the thing is, we got to learn how to be able to combat against the works of the enemy,
mm-hmm.
which is the sword of the Spirit,
mm-hmm.
meaning the Word of God.
Mm-hmm.
The Word of God is the only thing that can destroy the works of the enemy.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to suffer anymore with any sickness or disease. You don't have to suffer with anything that you're going through anymore. From this point on, anything you go through, 9 times out of 10, could be a choice instead of, I guess it's meant to be. It's not meant to be. As long as Abraham can say, what if decide to, the father of faith, to say, well, how about if you decide you can find 50 people in the community, 10 people in the community, 3 people in the community, would you spare the community?
Mm-hmm.
And he decided to spare Lot,
mm-hmm.
in his household. But the only one that wound up going out of Sodom and Gomorrah was who? Lot and his children, his daughters. Because his sons didn't want to leave that lifestyle. His wife, she was too connected. She didn't want to let it go. She had to look back to see what she was missing before she tried to go into what they would consider their safety zone. We're being attacked by so much type of parasites. I'm
going to read something real quick and then we're going to read that scripture, okay?
Parasites come through unclean animals, germs, bacteria, food, and even how it's prepared. When parasites enter in, to it, into its host, it lays eggs or larva, which is 100 eggs per 100 plus eggs per larva. They look like worms, maggots, and they're okay. I pretty much said that already, right?
Yeah.
Now let's look at this, Hosea. We're gonna bounce around, but we're gonna bounce around in this Hosea. Okay.
Okay.
Let's look at one real quick.
Okay. We just touched the.
Okay, there we go. Now let's look at this. It says, what does it say? It says, hear the word of who? Hear the word of what?
Of the Lord.
Ye who?
Children of Israel.
So now we know who God is talking to, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Right.
Now this is God talking, not the prophet, okay?
Yes.
But actually, no, this is the prophet. But you know, the funny part about this is it switches. Okay? So it says, hear the word of the Lord. Actually, it might be God. Yeah, it is. Hear the word of the Lord, ye children of Israel. For the Lord has, what?
Controversy.
Meaning God has an argument. God has a disagreement with you. God has a problem. God has an issue with you. Okay?
Uh-huh.
With the inhabitants of the land. Because what?
There's no knowledge of God in the land.
You
can say no.
No knowledge of God in the land.
So God got an issue with these people because there's no knowledge of God in the land. Because if there's no knowledge of God in the land, then that means that something's going on because this not God's not being preached.
That's right. Come on.
Okay? So the question is, what's being preached to the point that these people are dying? What's being preached to the point that these people are being infected by parasites? What's being preached that every time you look in, half the people in the church are dying?
Mm-hmm.
Mentally, physically, and spiritually.
Mm-hmm.
What's going on? It says, by swearing and lying and killing and stealing and committing adultery, they break what?
And blood touches blood.
Okay? Now look at 4. 4 says, therefore shall the land what?
Mourn, and mm-hmm. everyone that dwells therein.
Uh-huh. Shall
languish
with
the beasts of the field,
and with the fowls of heaven.
Ye shall, okay.
And the fishes of the sea also shall be taken away.
Now let's see. 4. Let no man strive nor reprove another, for thy people are as they strive with the priest. Right here it says that the people are just like the priest, or the priests are just like the people, meaning that you can't even tell them apart, because it's almost like this. You can't tell the motivational speakers and the life coaches and the ones that want to tell you how to live your best life now. It's hard to tell them from the preachers, because now the preachers want to be them.
Yeah.
And if you look online nowadays, you check out some of these bios, and that's what they say, motivational speaker. I almost got caught up in that because actually, I wanted to do that before I got called into the ministry. But as I began to start really looking into it, I realized how new it was, a new age philosophy.
Yes.
It's impossible to teach that without getting into new age philosophy. It's impossible. Some people say, well, it's not impossible. It's impossible. Because what happened is you've got to start off reading, you start off with scriptures. Then you go into philosophy. Then you start using other doctrines and other things. And next thing you know, you have a lot of lost people wondering, how do I tell the difference when you are bishop today and when you are pastor tomorrow?
Mm.
Because at some point, you're going to stop using God's name and start calling a higher power and so forth. Amen?
Amen.
What was that? 4. 5. Therefore, shall thou fall in the day, and the prophet also shall fall what?
With thee in the night.
So then they're saying that these preachers are hanging with the people that they're supposed to be saving souls. They're hanging with them, and the people that they're supposed to be saving souls have been a bigger effect on their life than them. So in reality, they're supposed to be saving the soul. Instead, in reality, they're losing their soul.
Yes.
Because it's almost like if you bring it up to today's thing, it's almost like we said earlier that the people had interpreted scriptures wrong. When Paul said, I became all things to all men, they thought that Paul meant he dressed like, act like, and be like. But Paul had the understanding of every person in every religion that he went to to convert or to lead to repentance, lead to the Lord. He knew their religion, he knew their religious beliefs, so he knew how to go to them. It's like this. Devil worshiper is a good witness to a one that's still in it because they know how to talk to them.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay? They begin to tell you that, you know, you thought this, and all that was you indoctrinating yourself and your family and your bloodline.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? your bloodline, because whatever I'm in now, it falls into my bloodline. Okay? That's like parasites, because I got to make sure I cleanse myself spiritually when I give my life to Christ, cleanse myself spiritually, because if I don't, then it's going to affect my child, and my child's going to go at one point in their life wondering, why am I going through what I'm going through? Not knowing that it was a generational curse attached to that lifestyle that I was living before I decided to say I give my life away. But yet, we find ourselves not knowing that we got fed by scavenger fish or scavenger creatures. Those are the ones, you know, scavenger fish that eat anything, waste, they eat whatever they're fed to them. Mm-hmm. And they tell us that you can live your life any kind of way you want. When God's ready for you to change, He'll change you, and that's the biggest lie from hell. Because what happened is, with that theology, it leads you to hell because it's literally eating you alive. Yes. Haven't you ever been to the point where you felt you were losing your mind? Mm-hmm. You felt as if no matter how much you tried to either get to God or get your situation, let's just drive on over to a realist situation, okay? You ever been in a situation where no matter what you try to do, you try praying, and you ever been in a situation where you tried to pray your way out of the situation, or no matter what you did, the more you tried, it seemed like the deeper you fall deeper into the rabbit hole, and it seemed as if you were losing your mind, you're crying out to God, God, why, and never knew that the reason I'm struggling is because this parasite is eating me alive, because I allowed false doctrine to eat me alive. Yes. And so it began to attack my heart. And once that thing gets into your heart, it's hard for a doctor to come in and start pulling parasites out your heart. That's it. Yes. Mm-hmm. It's easier for them to pull it out of your stomach or your intestine because they can give you something for it. Mm-hmm. But the moment it infects your heart, that's it. Yes. Amen?
Amen.
What was that?
And I will destroy thy mother. You was on five.
Five, okay. Therefore shall thou fall in the day. Oh, yeah, I did. So let's look and see. And then, this is the one that everybody in the world only know out of this whole chapter. I mean, isn't it true?
Yeah, it is.
You say, Hosea, they'll finish it off with you. Just like if I broke out and just, if you've been so pleasant, you just bust out and say, Our Father, who art in heaven. Everybody jump in.
Yes.
You know, it's like that's the only one they know from that particular text, mm-hmm. but they have no idea what the spiritual significance and the deepness and the depth of that particular saying is. Mm-hmm. They even say it at funerals and know that that's not for funerals. Mm-hmm. They say it in different places, knowing it's not meant for those certain places. But anyway, it says, therefore, my people are destroyed for what?
Lack of knowledge.
Now we begin to understand it's the knowledge of who?
God.
My people die, but my people Now, you know, we always go, my people are perished, but I never can find where that word perish come in at. Yeah, I know, that's right. You know, I'm like looking it up, I'm like, perish. But my people are what?
Destroyed.
Meaning that they're dying mentally, physically, spiritually. Meaning that they're infected with diseases, parasites. They're being destroyed by false doctrine. They're being destroyed by all kinds of things. Think about trying to get to God, and you're doing everything, you're going, you're running. You know God got a calling on you. You know God is doing something in your life, but you don't know how to connect. You know that I need some type of movement in my life.
People are preaching,
they're preaching songs that they've heard as sermons and quoting songs as scriptures, and so now people are infected and getting these paralysis, getting these things, these diseases, and they're wondering why I'm dying on the inside when I'm in church. Why am I dying on the inside? When? Why is it hard for me to find a job when I'm a believer? Mm-hmm. I pray every day. I get into the world. What is blocking me? And then as we begin to realize that we've been under so much parasite and parasitic things so long that infected a bacterial belief system and preaching and stuff, we've been under so much teaching and so much conversation because, see, what a parasite is, it's a leech. And what a leech can be a person, place, or thing. So a person, place, or thing, that means that I could have got attacked either in the church or just by hanging around somebody. Mm-hmm. And by being around the wrong person, that's why I said bird of the feather flock together, because that bird that's next to you that's infected gets you infected. It's almost like those zombie movies, because it bites you. And when it bites you, then the next person gets bit, and then it goes on like that dramatic scene, like dominoes. And we're asking ourselves, God, why can't I get a breakthrough? And the reason we can't get a breakthrough because we're constantly connecting ourselves with parasites, and the parasites are constantly laying the eggs. And when they lay the eggs, what's happening is breaking, is making walls and doors, is what's happening. And the more I get sick, the more it's hard for me to see. Mm-hmm. Because it begins to block my eyes. If you do any research on the colon, you begin to realize that when the colon is infected, it plays a big role in your skin. in your blood. It plays a bigger role on how you feel, your energy level, your stress level. It plays a big role, but then we look at ourselves feeding demonic spirits, not knowing it, because it makes us feel good at times. Think about it. Ask that person, why do they do drugs and alcohol? And they'll tell you, it makes me feel good at the time. So what's happening is they make this demonic forces makes them feel good at the same time. Mm-hmm. And what happened is they never know that when they drug the drugs and alcohol, the things that are shutting down kidneys and livers for such a long time, and then when the liver and the kidneys get enough time to breathe, you numb it again. Mm-hmm. It gets enough time to breathe, you're numb it again. And what happened is you don't have enough time for it to live. So the parasites come in, they begin to live off the flesh. It begins to live off of you. It begins to come out of your pores. It begins to come out of your skin. And then you begin to ask God, Lord, why me? Why is all this happening to me? I mean, have you ever been there before? Let's be honest. Why not this person who's finding themselves in and out of jail all the time? Why not this person? Not knowing that we're spreading curses, but I mean, think about it. In our deepest times, we say the weirdest things to God. God, why not this person? You know, why do bad things happen to good people? Why can't I find a job in this person, and every time they get a job, they can get a job. Every time you turn around, they get a job. You know those people, they can mess up on the job and quit a job and stay out for 2 seconds, and next year they get another job. But it's like, you look at it, you're like, well, why is it so hard for me to find a job? Because the simple fact is, because the parasite has blinded you to the things of God.
Yes.
And it caused us not to see what God is doing in our lives. It caused us not to see the witches that are spewing out and giving us that apple. Mm-hmm. You ever see that movie where the witch gave the apple to the lady? What is that?
Cinderella.
You look at it and she cuts the apple open in half. And then Cinderella, Snow White. I thought they both were the same.
Yes,
Snow White is a Cinderella.
It was a witch that did something to Cinderella.
Yeah, it's in one of the movies. It's in the Disney movie. Put it that way.
Yeah.
So anyway, she what happened was she poisoned the apple. They even did it in Oz.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So if you were saying all the Disney movies are the witches and the witches and the princess.
Right.
Okay,
right.
Let's just say that, because if you look at half the Disney movie, that's the theme of the movie. They put the person to sleep through poisoning them.
Right.
Okay. But then one time, this one particular witch, she decided, in this one movie, they decided to allow her to split the apple open and show you the stuff inside of it. And only certain people with a certain eye can see that the apple was infected. And so the lady bit the apple, and the moment she hit the apple, she got poisoned, she got infected, and the parasites got inside of her. How long will we allow ourselves to be sick and listen to any and everything? How long will we allow any and everybody to fix our plate for us without going home, taking notes on everything that we hear and see? The most dangerous thing is to die and know that you could have stopped it. The most dangerous thing is to have a loved one that's struggling and dying in the hospital. And everybody around said, well, you know what? If they die, then that means it's God's will.
Really?
They're 13 years old. You're trying to tell me it's God's will. God knew better. You're telling me he's 13 years old and God knows better. But yet, I read in my word and find out that I was supposed to lay hands on the sick, cleanse the disease, which they called the leper in those days. See, but the lepers were the people who had leprosy. Even animals had leprosy. Leprosy came through bacteria and germs and stuff like that. And so it's like the contagious and incubation stages of leprosy were not as strong as, I guess you could say almost like chicken pox. Mm-hmm. Because once you touch a person with chicken pox, you don't get it right away. It takes a while before that incubation stage to sit in.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Meaning the birth stages to kick in.
Right, right.
So he said, cleanse the leopard. Raise what?
The dead.
That means that as preachers, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel, to set at liberty those who are what? Abound. So then, if I'm called to raise the dead, I have to first start to show them that once you come alive, how not to die again.
Mm-hmm.
Until it's time for you to die. Once again to a man to live and then to the die. I'm just paraphrasing because I forget how it goes. I just remember once again to a man to live or something like that. But, oh yeah, is that Ecclesiastes? Anyway, we got to ask ourselves. And we're gonna finish this one on on Thursday. And then we're going to go into the spiritual paralysis. Then we're going to go into, because spiritual paralysis goes into spiritual, it goes into sleep paralysis, and it goes into some other dead things. Okay? So like I said, we're going to finish this Saturday, but I mean finish this Thursday, and then we're going to go a little, and then we're going to cap it off and go into spiritual paralysis on Saturday. But I'm going to end it like this. I told some of you that was here Thursday. I was like, I had placed something on the internet, on Facebook, and I haven't did any at all this week after I did that, because I'm learning that there are, I mean, I know, you know how you know that you know, but you didn't really care. Mm-hmm. I know there's rich witches out there, okay?
Oh, yes.
But sometimes I get things and I never realize how important, deep, or eye-opener, or what's that other word?
Truth,
or to the point that it delivers and set free. Or it just awakens, a word that awakens. And so I was talking about the time that I told you earlier. I said people are quick to prophesy this, people are prophesy that, but they never tell you when the time is. And I started talking about time, seasons, dominion, and realms, and I said, and I ended it with this. I said, if you realize God's timing, and you realize God's season, then you realize where we're at now. See, because the thing is, when you realize where we're at now, then you realize that you can be able to avoid a lot of stuff that you're going through. Then I ended it with this. Then you'll understand what deja vu is. Right? I did not sleep that night. I got so demonically attacked that night. It was it was real strong. I mean, it was so weird. I mean, I put the Bible on my chest and I tried to go back to sleep after praying, and I felt something trying to move the Bible from me. You know, it tried to get me to move it from me. So then I wrapped myself in my blanket that I had scriptures on, and it tried to get me to move that out from me. What am I saying? I'm saying that once we realize the power of when God said get up and pray, we have to. We have to realize that just because you see somebody walking around doesn't not necessarily mean that they're in human form.
That's true.
And I'm going to end it with that. And we're going to touch a little bit more on that next week, because it sounds ironic, it sounds weird. It's like, okay, you sound stupid, you sound, ooh. But if you begin to study the world begins to show you how to avoid. That's why it says, be aware that you might entertain angels unaware. If I can entertain angels unaware, can I entertain demonic spirits unaware?
Right.
Because in my last call, do you remember Preach Close three times? I was listening to someone, and they said, he said it's like this. The question is, what have you been listening to? What have you been hearing? And what have you been listening to? What have you been watching? What have you been seeing? Because that's how the parasites enter. And when they enter into to steal, kill, and destroy you. But if I change my eating habits, meaning get into the Word and allow God's Word to lead and guide me, and pay close attention, do my homework on the stuff that I eat, then God's Word can heal me. Because they come.